don't you just hate it when you wake up in the middle of the night to pee? And does it just keep happening every single night? Here are 5 ways to make that problem stop. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about 5 ways to stop waking up to pee. When you wake up to pee, you probably don't have enough of a hormone called anti-diuretic hormone. A diuretic is something that makes you pee, so an anti-diuretic hormone is something that stops you from peeing. That's also called ADH. Well, why not? One thing to note about ADH is that it's part of your circadian rhythm. You're supposed to make more at night to prevent you from getting up to pee while you're sleeping. So circadian entrainment, establishing the circadian rhythm, is key here. If you are sleeping radically different hours in the middle of the week as you are on the weekend, you are hurting your circadian rhythm because you are not making your sleeping time consistent. If you are trying to sleep consistently, but your sleeping behavior is erratic, then you are also missing your circadian rhythm. So it's very important to be sleeping at the same time every night or very close to the same time. Even if that might not be the best thing for your social life or your work life, you have to find a way to approximate getting consistent hours of sleep on a daily basis if you want everything to be optimized for sleep when you're sleeping, such as making the hormone that stops you from getting up to pee. So the Lite techniques that I talked about in the last episode and some of the tips that I'll give in the next episode about getting better sleep in general cover how to entrain the circadian rhythm, but it's really important that that rhythm be consistent, that you be sleeping at a consistent time every day. Number 2, salt. Salt actually makes you make more of ADH, the anti-diuretic hormone. So a little bit of salt before bed might help you. I would start with, say, 1/4 teaspoon, work your way up, and keep going up on a nightly basis till you find some amount that seems to be helping. Number 3, in order to make ADH, you need certain nutrients. The most important nutrients are copper, vitamin C, and zinc. I'll link in the episode description to episodes that I've done before on those nutrients. Also, if you want a guide to managing your status for those nutrients, check out Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet. If you don't already have a copy, you can get it at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet, and you can use the code LITE5, L-I-T-E, and the number 5 to get $5 off. Number 4, moving past ADH now, we can try to get deeper sleep. Some ways to help you get deeper sleep would be to take 3 to 6 grams of glycine on an empty stomach before bed, making sure that your room is as dark as possible, preferably blacked out, and that you're sleeping at a cool temperature. It should be the coolest temperature that you can sleep at without waking up or not falling asleep because you feel uncomfortably cold. In other words, maybe 60 degrees makes you uncomfortably cold, but maybe 63 or 64 or 65 is comfortable enough with the covers on that you're not irritated and annoyed at the cold. If that's the case, then it is much better to sleep at 63, 64, or 65 than it is at 70 degrees. If, as I mentioned in a previous episode, it might help for you to try a lower protein meal at the last meal of the day. If you're not sleeping deeply enough, then that's not something I would say you have to do, but it's something you could try. And then number 5, you want to keep your stress levels low. And that means eating enough total calories. And it means, because not eating enough is a form of stress in itself. And it means keep managing your other stress, your work life, your relationships, all your responsibilities. All those things need to be managed outside of your sleeping time in your daily life in order to maintain your stress levels low enough that you're getting nice deep sleep. This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Grass-Fed Beef Brain,
Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral supplements as a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, bone marrow, brain, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order.
The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount.
All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.